We are really knocking on the door of £100 for a 1 gram gold bar. And there were so many people that was hating on these going back just a few years ago. There is a new precedent when it comes to the value of gold bullion. Now, I've just come off of the back of a Sunday live stream here on Future Investments, and we got into a good topic debate about the current price of gold. From the last 10 years, it's up 153%. That's an increase of £1,171. And it got me looking at the current prices for an ounce of gold, a quarter ounce of gold, a 1 gram gold bar, and a 5 gram gold bar. So in this video, we're going to be talking about those prices and the possibility of it not being affordable going forward into the future. Okay, so I'm not going to beat around the bush. Gold right now is astronomically high when it comes to the value, and so is silver. Silver's just crossed over £20 an ounce, and I think it was about time that happened too, because in my opinion, silver was sitting at £16, £17 an ounce for far too long, and I think now that's crossed the threshold over £20 an ounce. I think that's the new benchmark regarding silver. Onto gold though, specifically for this video, the precious metal AU, gold is at £1,935 per ounce. And I think the new benchmark is going to be around £1,900 for gold. I don't see it going below that again, not unless something was dramatic that was going to happen. How does that affect the purchasing of gold? Well, it does make it difficult to buy gold right now. When you're used to a price of £1,600 an ounce, that's going to dramatically affect the purchases you're going to make regarding gold. Now, when we just look at the prices of bullion, I can look back at some of the purchases I've made at the end of last year and the beginning of this year compared to now. Now, I know what you're going to say, future investments, that's irrelevant. The gold price pretty much always goes up. Yes, it does. But to see such a huge price hike, a bit of a bull run like we've seen right now, it's unusual for gold because normally gold is pretty settled and it's not very volatile. So when we look at a 2023 1 ounce gold Britannia, which is a Queen Elizabeth piece from the Royal Mint, it's going to set you back £2,068 for an ounce of gold. Late last year, I bought one of those for around £1,650, £1,700. It's now £300, £350 more. That's historically high. I mean, just think about it. £2,000 for an ounce of gold. Yes, it's 24 carat, 4/9 fine, a capital gains tax exempt piece. We love all of that. But for such a small item, that's £2,068. I mean, we're talking vast, vast amounts of money now. I think for me personally, when it used to sit in sort of 2021, 2022, at around £1,400, £1,500 for an ounce of gold, I thought that was, you know, pretty standard. But now we've actually seen an ounce of gold cross over that £2,000 threshold, and quite far over it as well, £2,068. I think we're now at a price point where to buy an ounce of gold is a real challenge for most people. You know, even if you're good with budgeting and you have a good investment amount to invest in investment vehicles every month, £2,000, that's a lot of money. That is a lot of money to invest in a single item that you're going to be holding on to for the long term. You're locking in a lot of capital into an asset that you're not going to really want to be selling off pretty soon after your purchase. That's just not what you want to be doing with gold. So yes, on the flip side, it's a positive, because if gold keeps increasing the way it does, yeah, that investment is going to turn out to be a very nice yielding investment going forward. But £2,000 for an ounce? Wow, I mean, we're talking about serious levels of investment now. Let's move it down a notch. Quarter ounce gold Britannias. I bought quarter ounce gold Britannias last year for about £450, £460. And now they're £551, over half a £1,000, £551 for a quarter ounce gold Britannia. I mean, we're talking big, big numbers here now for gold bullion. I think we're definitely getting to the point when people are going to have to only consider buying fractional bullion, 1/10 ounce gold Britannias, and 1 gram gold bars. And I'll get more onto that in a minute, but seriously, the price is so high right now. Yes, it's positive. Of course we want the price to go up. That's why we invest in it. It's a wealth preservation device and it's a hedge against inflation. It's the best form of savings account you can get. If you're investing in legal tender pieces minted by the Royal Mint in the UK, you're getting capital gains tax exempt pieces as well. There's so many benefits to gold. But as a buyer, this is going to really hamper how people are buying bullion. I'm not looking at this from a negative. I'm just looking at this as a realist on the possibility of purchasing bullion now. It's so expensive. And I think that's possibly going to push a lot more people to get this fractional bullion, or maybe even move more on to getting more silver instead of gold. Let's look onto 5 gram gold bars then. When I bought my very first Britannia gold bar from the Royal Mint in about 2020, so we're talking 4 years ago, I paid £250, give or take a couple of pence. Now it's £350. I mean, £100 yield in 4 years. On a consistent, safe investment. That's a fantastic ROI on a safe investment. And when we look at gold, we don't even buy it. We don't even invest in it to get rich. We invest in it to keep ourselves rich, to preserve our wealth and hedge against inflation. So I'm looking at it from a huge positive here. My precious metal stack has dramatically gone up in value. And of course, am I happy about that? Absolutely. Who wouldn't be? Who doesn't want to get a great ROI on their investment? But I'm also looking at it from a different perspective as a buyer. How can I stomach spending £350 on a 5 gram gold bar, or £558 on a 1/4 ounce gold Britannia, or over £2,000 for an ounce of gold? I mean, holy shit. We're talking about big levels of money now. When we look at 1 gram gold bars, at the start of this year, I was picking up 1 gram gold bars for £55, £56 per gram from bullion dealers with delivery. That was good to me. I've just had a look on the same bullion dealer's website, Tavex Bullion, £75 with postage. Insane. Absolutely insane. I looked at Next Day Bullion for their Oxford Mint Britannia bar, £79. For a 1 gram gold bar. We are really knocking on the door of £100 for a 1 gram gold bar. And there were so many people that was hating on these going back just a few years ago because they didn't see the reason of investing in 1 gram gold bars. But as I've said it before, and I've always stuck by my guns, these 1 gram gold bars, yes, the premiums are high. You're getting absolutely hammered on those. But it's going to be the only affordable precious metal that most people can buy. Who's going to have £2,097 to buy 1 ounce gold Britannia? Who's realistically going to have the money to buy that? Yes, maybe you've got some inheritance or you've got some savings, but you're not going to be able to invest on that on a dollar cost averaging basis, on a regular basis. Heck, £558 for a quarter of an ounce? I don't really see many people that are going to be able to justify doing that every single month on one a month. I mean, if you can, fantastic. You're buying into an investment that's going to preserve your wealth. But the values now are getting so high that it's getting very expensive. And yes, I know what you can say is, well, you're not including inflation, future investments and the increased rates of pay. Of course, people are earning more money. So therefore, is £551 for a 1/4 ounce gold Britannia relative to £460 for one end of last year? I don't think it is relative. I think the proportion is despondent between what it was now and what it was in at the end of last year. I think it's become harder to get hold of a 1/4 ounce gold Britannia than it was to buy one at the end of last year. I don't think in any way, shape or form, pay increases have kept up with the rate of gold's increase. And that's a real concern for regular buyers and people who want to buy these 1/4 ounce 5 gram gold bars, 1 ounce gold coins. It's going to push people to have to consider looking at 1/10 ounce gold coins or 1 gram gold bars. And listen, I'm all for it. I believe it's better to have some gold rather than no gold. I'm not one of these haters that hates on smaller fractional pieces because of the premiums. I think that if you're buying gold, whether it's 1 gram or an ounce, You're doing better than whoever's not buying them. You could be spending that money on something that isn't going to preserve your wealth and hedged against inflation. You could be buying crap, essentially. Let's get to the point. So yes, I think nonetheless, what you're buying doesn't matter because you're buying an asset that's going to look after your wealth. But the price hike is going to force people to have to consider looking at these lower value pieces like 1 gram gold bars and 1/10 ounce. So let's just look at the price of gold in the last 10 years. 10 years ago, it was worth £694 at its lowest, and right now it's worth £1,935. That's an increase of 153%. So if you invested £10,000 at its lowest point 10 years ago, your £10,000 would be worth £25,000. I mean, talk about an ROI on an investment that's considered low risk, low volatility. That is an unbelievable return. So if you invested 10 grand right now, could that be 25 grand again in the next 10 years or more? Who knows? But right now, we know for sure gold is very expensive. I am a believer that it's better to have time in the market than rather trying to time the market. But nonetheless, it does make you question whether you should wait out these prices and possibly wait for a dip in the market to get a better P&E ratio, price to earnings ratio purchase. So overall, gold's expensive. We know that. It's going to definitely push people to more fractional pieces of gold bullion. But nonetheless, I think if you buy fractional or an ounce and up, either of those is a good purchase. But it's definitely something to watch going forward into the future. Thanks very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you all in the very next episode. I want to give a big shout out to everyone who has donated a super chat. 365 with £5, Cobra Stacker with £9.99, Rory Sailor with £20, The Stack Collector with £5, 365s with £1.99, Cobra Stacker with £3, Metalhead Money with 79p, Cobra Stacker with £1.99, William Gray with £20, Constitutional Stacker with £5, 365 Days of Silver £9.99, Bullion Breakdown with £5.50, Silver Stacker £1.99, Shine Bright Like a Diamond at 99p, 365 Days of Silver at £4.99, The Stack Collector at £5, 365 Days of Silver at £9.99, Jacob at £4.99, GKK at £1.99, 365 at £4.99, Stack Collector at £5, Stack Collector at £2, Stack Collector at £1.90, and 365 at £1.99. Thank you to everyone for the super chats.